Hello, everybody. Welcome back. It is Jeff again, and something is interesting with the death games. There are two people up in the death games. Maybe there's been an update to it. I am not sure. But the good thing is, I know that I'm not up in the death games, and nobody who's on the server is up either, so that is not my concern right now. But I'll be back with you guys momentarily. Gonna go back to base and prepare for the day. Check this out, everybody. Yay! I have a fence gate now. Everybody keeps talking about the fact that coming up soon, when we update the server, the baby zombies will be able to get in through this little one wide gap. And I was actually thinking about waiting and seeing when we updated how many times I just get swarmed by the babies, but I decided instead of doing that, I would just put the gate up preemptively. And I'm gonna fix this stuff up later. As you can see, I'm pretty big on unfinished projects. So, on that note, let's go start another unfinished project. I mean, I can't really say it's an unfinished project that hasn't started yet, but we'll start another project that will soon be unfinished. No, hopefully I'll actually finish this one. I've grabbed with me, let me get out of the portal, my wolves. I'm going to go claim spots in the spawn area to make the temporary first aid tent until the hospital is finished. I don't have any prevalence at spawn, so I want to make something. I haven't scoped it out yet to know how dire the pickings are for the land, so we will find out really soon. Many people did comment on my last video how the mic sounds so much better, and they're really happy that I got a new mic. And I will tell you, it is not a new mic. I'm just an idiot. I basically discovered that I had clicked on something, and even though I had my mic level set properly, okay, so this is still in regeneration. Who is this? Donor recognition award. I need it to be in a regeneration spot. That is kind of key for the fact that it is a first aid. Oh, that's sold to MC Gamer. I'm not going to buy land from somebody. Well, I'm not buying craft from you guys. I will just claim myself something. Leasing, expiring, lot number two. I like how this one's for lease, yet already built. I actually think that's built by the B team. I might just grab a spot over here on this side of the road, because that's fine. The first aid tent needs to not be necessarily a main part of this area, but I just need it to be close enough to still hit the regeneration so that it gives the feel of a first aid tent. So, kind of anywhere here, that would be a nice one actually. How much is this one? For sale. I'm not gonna call B Team Realty. I'm not even going to mess with them. I am just gonna go make myself a spot right off over here on this side. Is this area claimed? This probably is claimed actually because of the chests and such there. But while I'm scoping out looking for land, yeah, I'm an idiot. There was a setting that I had. I thought my levels were all fine, and I accidentally like right-clicked on something the other day, which brought up the other menu for audio that I hadn't really messed with because I thought it was fine. Yet turns out I had turned my Minecraft volume and my mic volume were well below the system volume level, even though it said the levels were fine. It was very strange. You know what? These torches, I'm sure, are actually just here for... Oh, that's the horse stables. I was gonna say, I'm sure they're just here to keep this thing, let me see. How do I get land at spawn? Maybe I will deal with B-Team Realty. But either way, I adjusted the levels of them in this secondary level window up to the normal level, and I'm eyeing, I can't spell. I'm looking at a piece of land. What is the price? I still love this thing. This thing is hilarious. Did I bring cobble with me? I did not. Aww. I could start the show with something else, but that is not what it's intended for. Oh, here's the generic. Let's see what he comes back with. What's the cheapest lot left? How about six? Can I have half a six? I don't need it this big. My first A10 is not going to be a huge tent here. But anyways, I fixed the volume level on the mic, which obviously is coming through. I could tell the second I made my last video and I was rendering it, I was like, wow, I really fixed something there that's been bothering people for a long time because it was so... Where'd he go? What a horrible realtor. Comes and just shows off a plot of land and is like, yeah, I don't want to show it to you anymore. Pyro's just on a mission, man. He's out of here. I should tell Generic that Pyro's up in the death games. Which ones are even left? Pyro, you are a dick. See, where is farmland lots? Farmland lot. I just annexed your lot, Pyro. Oh, farmland sale, lot number 5. What a shitty piece of land. It doesn't even have regen in it. Lot 5 is farmland. It comes from the with the cows and the sheep, even. Oh, this whole thing is lot 5? Wait, this actually might be kind of cool. Oh, because there's regen right here? I can make part of it in the regen and part of it not? I'll give 2... half-used golden helmets from a zombie drops first. Oh, where'd the regen go? It had regen for a second. I got the particle effect, but I don't actually have the regen. That's really strange. What effect is going on over here? Wow, there's a horse. Oh wait, I'm very confused at how this beacon is working here now. Am I just not seeing the beacon right? I'm staring right at it and I'm not getting, that's still the Wild Wild West out there. Claim and build. I'll find my own land here. But I'm not getting, why am I not getting this, My particle effects. No, particle effects obviously are on. Maybe you just don't do the regen if you're not, if you don't need it. I don't know that. Either way, long story short, that was just a big waste of time. But besides that, it is, Mike is working much better, which I'm very happy with. Ooh, zombie. What is this dude doing out here in the sunlight? Okay, he's just one of those guys. What is all this stuff over here? There's creepers. There's things everywhere. Yeah, I'm going to scope around for a little bit, find myself a plot of land to build on, and do some building. I will see you guys in a minute. Ah, you know what? This is perfect. I actually didn't realize that this apparently is Pause's police station. Is this jail? yep, this is jail. I was going to say that it is going to be perfect because... I didn't even read what he said anymore. We were talking about a deal, but lost myself for 30 plus diamonds. Ha! Huh. No sale. I just got myself trapped in Pause's police station. That's funny. I'm going to. Boink. I could just make a button to get out of there, but I did not have one on me. So there we go. This is the police station, though. I figured the police station is probably a perfect location to have MBTC's donuts. Well, that's funny. A perfect place to have a first aid tent by. So I could put a first aid tent right here and just, if it's illegal, I guess I'm close enough to the police station that it doesn't really matter. It's not even going to be that big. So let's get some building going on here and see what we can come up with. Because I want this thing, it's not going to be that big, it's just going to be about like that. Oh no, I can't go in front of the donut shop. I have the shears on me. Oh. That's pretty small. I'll need a little bit bigger than that. Oops. Something like that. Maybe here? I might be too close to him. I hope. We'll see if he gets upset at where it is. We'll find out. We'll find out. It's just wool. It's going to be simple and easy to break apart. So I'm not that concerned with it. It's going to be a tent style is what I'm going for. And then I'm going to try to somehow put a cross in it. And I'm not quite sure how that's going to look. I might need to make it a bigger tent style because this is going to be pretty, pretty chintzy. Oh, shoot. What am I doing? Oh man, and I'm almost out of red wool already. I didn't realize how much wool it's going to take in order to... Oh, what am I doing? What am I doing, man? What am I doing? Yeah, it's going to take a lot of wool to get this thing done. I'm going to have to go back and get my my supply going again. While I'm building this, just small little first aid, I just wanted to get something in here to show that, you know, a presence at spawn, because I don't have one. And this was suggested by one of the viewers, and I thought it was a great idea to actually make a first aid tent, which is specifically what they suggested, because they said, you know, based on, you know, what you do, your profession, this and that, it would be a really cool idea to have just a little presence here at spawn, first aid tent. I don't know if this is going to be the color I will use, because I really wanted to keep it red on the sides and then give it a white cross on it to show, which is actually the Ski Patrol logo, but also the standard old first aid logo. I could have made it white actually with a red cross, which would be, you know, red cross. I don't know. So, I mean, this could go through a couple iterations. It's just wool. It's not much. It's very obtrusive right now. Yeah, I don't know how I would make this thing currently to give it a cross pattern without going to get more wool. Let me go see if I can go get more wool from the house. Just gotta wait for some sheep to grow it. We'll see what that looks like. While I'm doing this, it was fun. I was actually talking to somebody this weekend, or you know, at the fire station last night. Regarding, we're talking about coupons for some odd reason. I don't know if one of those coupon shows was on TV or whatever, those extreme couponers or whatnot. And it reminded me of when I used to work at McDonald's, and all restaurants for the most part, and they might not advertise this, but oh, you know, I just realized part of my plan won't work with that lot because it's not big enough. We'll have to see. I can still make it work. I can still make it work in a slightly different way. No, that's fine. But most restaurants and things like that, they actually take competitors' coupons. And I don't know if most people know that. That's not something they necessarily all advertise. But for the most part, they will all take competitors' coupons. Like if you go to McDonald's with a Burger King coupon, they will accept it for a reasonable substitution that they can. You know, obviously they don't have Whoppers, but they have, you know, the similar sandwiches that they could make for you. So it might not be the exact same thing. So, you know, you'd make, especially as the manager, you kind of were the one at the discretion who got to decide what the coupon was, you know, kind of good for. But we used to have, also, we had senior Cokes on the menu. Well, we called them senior drinks, but everybody called them the senior Cokes. And I didn't grow up in an area that called everything Coke either, which is kind of weird, that everything was called Coke. But the, oh, that was dumb. The senior drinks were 27 cents a piece instead of, you know, a buck or whatever it was. So it was a significant discount for the seniors. It was mainly for coffee, Coke, etc. You know, they'd come in there and they'd get their stuff. But the thing is, with any deal, you can't get a value meal and substitute the, where's my weed? Am I just overlooking my wheat here? But you can't get a value meal and substitute a cheap drink in place of the drink with the value meal. The value meals are supposed to be priced at a certain amount, and it's based on the combination, which always would make people upset when you know, had a special for like any size drink is, you know, a dollar or something like that. And then people would be mad, well, how come my value meal didn't go down because, you know, the price of the drinks are cheaper. And actually sometimes they would, the depending on the type of sale it was and the way it was rung up in the system, because sometimes the drink was priced out separately and then you would get away with actually doing that. But most of the time, like, the drink was priced into those special, or into the meal itself. The meal was just a blanket amount of money and you specified what kind of drink it was. But that being said, we had this one lady, she used to come in all the time, and she was an older woman, and she was eligible for the senior discount because whoa, because she was definitely elderly. She was probably, oh no, I just, why? How many zombies you gonna summon, dude? And why is my kitty after me now? You're a jerk. Kill you. Yeah, stealing my stuff, stealing each other's flesh. But she used to come in every single day, and she would argue regarding the senior drinks, because she'd always want the senior drinks with whatever meal it was that she got. Oh, that was one road too far. And we would tell her every single day that she wasn't allowed to do that, blah blah blah. But she just always would stand there and acting like she didn't know what was going on. And she wasn't senile or anything. People knew her outside. Some people knew her outside of the restaurant, outside of McDonald's, and knew that she wasn't like a senile lady just going crazy. But she would just put on this dumb face. I guess it's a good way to do an argument if you're really good at arguing, is to put on a dumb face and continue on, and people are eventually going to give in, because we often would, because she just caused such a problem sometimes that it wasn't worth it to, you know, upset this old woman. And then, holy crap, and then all these people are, you know, mad at you because they think you're, you know, mistreating the elderly or whatever. So very often it was, you know, the store manager would be like, just let her do it. Let her do whatever she wants to do. So it'd be like, okay, where'd you come from? You can't even get in here. Did I breed you? I guess you technically can get in there. Ow, yeah, you can get in there right there. Which I see now. All I want is some wool. Leave me alone so I can get my wool. Where'd you go? Oh, there it goes. Leave me alone so I can get my wool, okay? Thank you. Just want to breed some more of these gentlemen and ladies, hopefully, and ladies. But on top of that, like, she would always get away with this. Dessert. She ended up with a meal for, like, so cheap because it was, you know, she'd get this drink on top of it, but she'd always come in with a coupon, but never a McDonald's coupon. And we do have coupons at McDonald's. There's a decent amount of coupons at McDonald's. And she would always come in with a coupon that was not a McDonald's coupon and want a, you know, us to honor the coupon. Most of the time, we would have no problem with it. Oh, I was like, what? Most of the time, we would have no problem with it because it was something similar. But she started just coming in with these coupons. I mean, ridiculous coupons, like 10-piece bucket at KFC. And she'd be like, I'd like this coupon honored, please. And we're like, I don't know what you want in replacement for this. And she's like, well, I don't know, but you guys honor competitors' coupons. It's like, yes, but we don't even sell this item. Like, nothing even close to, at the time it was, the only close thing you had was chicken nuggets. They didn't even have, like, the chicken selects or anything back then. It was like, do you want a bucket full of chicken nuggets? Like, I don't understand. I think once she actually showed up with, like, a coupon for an all-you-can-eat Chinese buffet, and it was just like, come on, lady, like, what are you gonna do? But we would always laugh, and people who were there every day, you just got to know who this woman was and deal with her in whatever way. It was, you know, some of it was your, you know, comical. He can't get through yet, right? Yeah. No, he can't get through yet. Some of it was like comical relief for the day because it was just like that moment of, oh, here she is again. What's going to happen? But she walked extremely slowly. She walked with a cane, and she walked. She didn't drive, she didn't take the bus, she walked. And you'd see her on the sidewalk coming up, just like, slowly heading toward the door, like, you know, inching her way up there, you know, like this. And you'd see her coming in, like, every single day. And once, it was, after years of dealing with this woman, I worked at McDonald's for an extremely long time, so after years of, whoa, stuck in a corner, no. No. Where's my potion? Drink it quickly. Woo. But I looked out the window and I saw her get out of the McDonald's. She got up to the sidewalk and she got to an area that was normally had been out of sight, but they were doing construction, so they had taken down a fence over in this area so you could see farther down the road. And I am not kidding you, I watched her slowly walk and then all of a sudden pick up her cane in her hand and just be like, like down the street. I was laughing so hard. Somebody came up to the counter and they were like, Jeff, what is wrong with you? And I just pointed because you could still see her. And they didn't think it was funny at all. They thought, they were like angry that this woman had been like, I don't know, quote unquote, playing us for years or whatever. But I never laughed so hard in my life. And I will tell you, after that moment, every time I saw that woman in the store, not only could I not stop laughing, but I honored anything that she wanted with those coupons because I was like, that's like some tricky bastard old lady that I just thought it was. I had a lot of respect for her, and I don't know why. I don't know if I should have, but I did. I had a lot of respect for her pulling off that, I don't know, con? Can you call that a con? I mean, I guess you could call it a con. It was a con of some type, and it was for something that was so stupid, but it definitely made me laugh, and it made my day. And I just wanted to share that with you guys because I was telling it last night at the fire station, and people, I don't know if they got the comedy factor out of it that I got out of it, but I enjoyed it personally. You know what I need to do? I will show you what I'm going to do with this thing before I end this episode, even though I still don't think I have enough to make it. Oh, yeah, fence post, perfect. Even though I don't have enough to finish it, but my goal is, and I don't know how this is going to work, but I think somebody else has done it, which gave me the idea. And that's why I'm, unfortunately, I don't think I have as many, as much space to do it because of the, where did I even choose to put this thing? Over here. So what I'm going to do is put a fence post up at the top of each one of these ends. I probably should switch this out for red because I think it's going to be red in the end. Or is it going to be white in the end? I'm going to switch it all the white or all the red. I don't know. I can always change it. But fence post there. And I'm going to do about like right here. And I want to get a chicken to hatch in this hole. Perfect. I can't lasso a baby chicken, can I? I cannot. So for now, I'm going to cover this with pink wool and go on, what is it? 1, 2, 3 in the second row. So like right there, I'm going to do the same thing down here and I'll have to come back when they're grown up when I believe you can lasso chickens. And I'm going to hook up these leads to them up to the top of up to the top of the tent. Yeah, you can't lasso the baby chicken. Up to the top of the tent and have it so it has like its tent that's actually held up by something, even though it's backwards. I was going to do it from like one from here on the side down, one from here on the side down, but I realized I can't do that over here because of the police station. I mean, maybe I still could. Maybe I still could. I don't know. I'll get some chicken set up in there just in case. Oops, sorry, bud. Like there, what is that? 2 in from the end. I can't quite do... Oh, yeah, I can do 2 in, because it's not going to be obtrusive to this. There we go. So I got the 2 there. How many am I out? I don't want it that far out. I like right here. Right here. Because I think this will end up being... Oops, actually right there. I think this will end up looking pretty... pretty cool. I could be wrong. And it could be something that I take away extremely quickly if I am wrong. I might need to go get more eggs. I have plenty of eggs at the house, though. There's no question about that. And then, like, this one. Wow. That worked out perfectly, except that I got an extra chicken in there. So there. So that's what that's going to be. And I still might do the 2, 4, 6. Yeah, I don't need to do any in the back because of the donut shop. That might look okay. I think I can deal with that. I'm going to now make sure I put a sign up on this thing so people knows whose it is. And hopefully it doesn't get taken out by the police. Or by those running the... Did I throw the leads in the guy? No, I didn't. Jay Sano first aid tent. Wait, actually... He put a really cool sign on his. I probably should give this thing a better sign. But, for the time being, first aid tent. JC 019. Yeah, but for the meantime, I can use the wool that I have to finish at least covering the back until I run out of wool. Which I just did. But yeah, so that's what this is going to be, and I'll probably come back to you guys momentarily and get these chickens, some of them lassoed up, if I can. We will see, so I'll see you guys momentarily. Okay guys, this is going to be bad. I'm going to be stuck in Doc's death loop here in a minute. I made a horrible mistake, got slain by a zombie, and my gate is open. Why didn't I just use the block? Why didn't I just use the block? Okay, I got out of there. Collect some of this stuff at least. Get out before I die. Okay, got some of this stuff back. Let me at least get it over here to my bed. And did I get my sword? No, I got a pick though. A diamond pick. I'm trying to get those zombies. All my sheep are escaped at this point. Which is fine, not that big of a deal. It's more a matter of making sure my diamond stuff doesn't go. Okay, you're down there, sheep. You can stay down there. There's one zombie left down in here. But there's also a zombie wearing my armor and holding my diamond sword somewhere. He is the man I must find. Oh, there's a pig man. Hi, piggy. I tried to escape through the portal. Oh, there's a sword. Good. I tried to escape through the portal, but the guy with my stuff came and got me. So I think he's waiting for me right there. They were in my house. Yep, this is the dock death loop. There is no question on that. At least he's in the nether for now. I can put some of this stuff away. All I wanted to do was get some more wool and show you guys something. That's all I wanted to do. A lot of that stuff's still over there in the nether. Let me grab... I need to make some, like, rudimentary armor or something just so I last long enough to be able to... Do I have any chest plate? Oh, perfect. I got a full protection 2 chest plate. That'll work. That'll work. And I'm gonna have to make an iron sword. I'm gonna have to do this. I know this episode is gonna run extremely long because of all the things I've been doing and this happening at the very end of it, but that's okay. It's all part of the game. I just gotta come in here. If I come in this way, there he is. There's that little bastard. Rah. Bye bye, kitty. Send a cat up through Sweden. Oh, that's awesome. Good. I got my sword back. I got my red wool back. I got my. Hey, that's pretty much all I wanted. Whatever. Death happens. I'm only at 28 now, though, which is kind of amazing. After that, I just died 4 times at least. Hee hee. Go to Sweden. That cat's gonna go for a ride. That I should just put it in his in Anders' area just for good. But oh no, I left my leads back at home. Crap. I wanted to get those. But either way, I just want to finish this off really quick. And I've adjusted it a little bit. Actually, yeah, you know what? I need those leads. I've adjusted it a little bit. I made it smaller. But I'll show you guys in a minute. Alright, so here it is. I don't know if I like the entrance to it and the way it works. The cross fits great, but it makes it so there's no good door to get in. I don't know if I like those. A good, I can lead this chicken. Whoa! I think that's too high for the chicken. so... Hell, that being said, that's not gonna work like I hoped it would. Can I just hook this here first? No. You think it'll go to the side one without pulling this chicken all the way out? No, just too far, huh? Can I go to this one and lead this chicken out? Oh, I don't have any seeds anymore. Crap. Well, that makes it difficult. So this isn't going to work out quite as I had hoped it would, but it's a work in progress nonetheless. This one might be okay, though. You? Y'all. And then all I need to do is get you covered with dirt. Yeah, those leaves don't go out as far as I hoped that they would, which is unfortunate. I'll have to get something. I'll have to mess with something here in order to... So, see, that'll work, but you can't even see the lead anymore. I mean, it's... Yeah, that's not even, like... That's not even purposeful. And I can't push this chicken anymore. I wonder if I can get some,
Yeah.
I don't know about this. Well, he laid eggs at least. You'll have to figure this one out a little bit more, but right now it's just got chickens tied to it. It was supposed to be leads. We'll figure something out. Okay, I'll see you guys next time.